we have seen here, so whenever here we are calling new test, so here we are calling parameter constructor. So whenever user or programmer has not written any parameter constructor or default constructor, in that case only compiler will add only default constructor, will add, it never add any argument constructor. Means whenever programmer has not written any constructor, then only compiler will add only default constructor like this. This is one example. Now let us move to another example here. Here I have written one class emp, one variable int salary, one constructor I have written argument constructor, then another class I took here, then here main method, and we are creating some object here like second object, third object we are creating. Okay, so let us come here. This is a test class, class test one. Here we are saying new emp of 3000, means it will create one object. Whenever new comes, automatically it will create an object after emp. In emp what we have? Salary we have. So emp we have salary, one object will be created with salary. Int means it is default is 0, right? But for emp we are passing 3000, so this is argument constructor. So here with emp we have one argument constructor, so this 3000 will be passed to here, 3000. But yes, we are putting it SEL, so that 3000 will be stored in SEL. So here 3000 will be stored in SEL, and this object we are storing in object reference called E1, therefore the name is E1. So here whenever you say new EMP, here since your argument is there, so argument constructor is called here with argument 1, so 3000 is stored in S, from S we are storing back to the SEL. So here, and this object is referred by E1, so E1 containing this one with salary value as 3000. And system.out.println E1 is this object reference, E1.sal. So E1.sal means this value 3000. So this 3000 will be printed here. So in the output here, 3000 will be, for this output is 3000. So 3000 will be printed. Now let us create one more object. Like new EMP 5000 I am passing this time. What happens? Again here also constructor will be called, because 5000 so it is the value, so this parameter or constructor will be called. So this 5000 will be assigned to S, then this S again we are storing in SEL. So one more object will be created with SEL, and 5000 will be assigned, will be into that, and object reference is E2 in this case. So we are storing into E2 with value 5000, one more object will be created with E2 name. Okay, now again we are printing the system.out.println E2.sal. So E2.sal means 5000 will be printed. Now let us create third object with new EMP. But here, whenever new EMP means object will be created, but EMP means what? Default constructor. It will go on to search, inside only one constructor is there, that is parameter constructor. But there is no default constructor. In case, if there is no constructor, for example in previous case there is no constructor programmer has written, in that case only compiler is added a default constructor. But here in this case you already have one argument constructor, so compiler is not going to add us any default constructor. So only we have one argument constructor, but we are trying to create here using default constructor. So compiler will not allow us, so it will throw compiler error, and it will throw, so telling because there is no default constructor is available. So we must go and add one default constructor, because programmer has already written one argument constructor, compiler is not adding any default constructor. So it is programmer responsibility here to add one default constructor without any arguments. That's why compiler will throw error.